Hi friend, today I would like to share with you about topic of neurology. What does neurology mean? Neurologist is a medical doctor that specializes in the study, diagnosis, treatment, and management of injury, disease, and disorder of nervous system. The nervous system includes the brain, spinal cord, and it makes up two parts, the central peripheral nervous system. What does neurology treat you for? Neurologists are specialists who treat disease of the brain and spinal cord, peripheral nerve and muscle. Neurological conditions include epilepsy, stroke, multiple sclerosis, and Parkinson's disease. Why would you need to see a neurologist? A neurologist treats disorder that affect the brain, spinal cord, and nerve. When you face serious conditions like stroke, Alzheimer's disease, multiple sclerosis, and it's difficult to find a doctor for you. Your brain is a memory function, depend on good blood flow and healthy nerve to work well. What tests do neurologists do? What is neurological examination? A neurological examination assesses motor and sensory skill, hearing and speech, vision, coordination, and balance. It may also test mental status, mood, and behavior. The examination due to such as a turning fork, flat line, the black hammer, and a tool for examining the eye. Does a neurologist treat anxiety? Additionally, a neurological diagnosis can often lead to anxiety and depression. Therefore, the neurologist and complete neurological care are always on the lookout for symptoms of depression and stress. Our neurologist can sometimes treat your anxiety. What is the cause of neurological disorder? The specific cause neurological problem vary, but can include genetic disorder, congenital abnormality or disorder, infection, lifetime environmental health problem, include more nutrition, and brain injury, spinal cord injury, nerve injury, and loosen sensitivity. Can stress cause neurological problem? Symptom of functional neurologic disorder may appear suddenly after a stressful event with emotional or physical trauma, or the trigger may include changes or disruption in how the brain functions at structural, cellular, or metabolic level. But the trigger for symptoms can always be identified. Is anxiety a neurological condition? Anxiety may be a symptom of reaction to neurologic disorder, a medication side effect, or comorbid condition. The most common anxiety disorder seen in neurologic patients are panic disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, social phobia, and obsessive compulsive disorder. Can neurological problem be cured? In many instances, nerve damage cannot be cured entirely. However, there are variable treatments that can reduce your symptoms. Because nerve damage is often progressive, it is important to consult with doctor when you first notice symptoms to reduce the likelihood permanent damage. Good root is a good for nerve. Apart from that, avocado also help improve memory and concentration. The best thing about avocado is they have high protein and low fat sugar content as compared to any other fruit. Almond has high level brain healthy omega-3 fatty acids and lot of brain protecting vitamin E, just like the salmon fish. What food are good for neurological health? My diet: green, leafy vegetables like kale and pineapple, all other vegetables and beans, berry, blueberry, cranberry, and blackberry, whole grain like oatmeal, quinoa, and brown rice, calcium-rich food like low-fat and non-fat dairy. Eat banana good for the brain. Study so eating banana helps you then learn more efficiently and improve exam score. They also contain vitamin B6, which promote the production of serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine to support concentration. How do I choose a neurologist? To a neurologist with whom you are comfortable talking and who supports your information needs. Neurologic diseases are complex and demand accurate and truthful conversation between neurologic and patient. Treatment decisions often hinge more on your discussion than sophisticated scale. What is full neurological exam? A neurological examination is the assessment of sensory neuron and motor responses, especially reflexes, to determine whether the nerve system is impaired. This typically includes a physical examination and a review of patient's medical history, but not deeper investigation such as neuroimaging. Remember, subscribe to see the next video. Thank you.